Hello everyone, welcome to Art Tree. Today I am going to tell you how to create the effect of batik print on paper. Batik is basically an Indonesian method of producing design on fabric with the use of wax resist. But here we are going to try to create the same effect on paper. As you can see, I have taken a cartridge sheet here and I have already drawn a peacock on it. You can draw any design of your choice on the sheet, but make sure that the design is not too intricate, otherwise your print won't be visible clearly. So quickly I'll tell you the material which we need for creating this print. We need wax oil pastels and we need to cover the whole sheet with this oil pastel. Each and every part of the sheet has to be covered with the wax layer. Even if you want to color some part as white, you need not leave it paper white. You need to cover it with white oil pastel. Then you will be needing any dark poster color. I have taken black and blue. You can take any dark poster color to be used as dye. Then I have taken a brush. You need a ball pen or a permanent marker to create the outline of your drawing. So with this pen I'll be creating the outline, and here I have taken a little bit hand wash in a bowl. You can use a detergent powder also instead of this, but I'm going to use this hand wash. And I'll be telling you how to use it later. So now I'll start creating the outline to my drawing. As you can see, the process of dyeing a cloth with batik print is entirely different. Here we are just going to create the effect of batik on paper. So we will first be creating a layer of wax on the sheet, and then we will be de-waxing some parts of the sheet by creasing it, and then we will dye the sheet and we will wash it off. Sounds horrible. Let's see how we are going to do it. It is really going to be an amazing experience creating this print on paper. Now I have done with the outline. I'm going to color the whole sheet with the oil pastel. You can choose any color of your choice, but make sure that the layer of oil pastel is quite thick. Do not cover a large part of your sheet with very dark colors, otherwise the texture won't be visible clearly once we dye it with any dark color. So try to use as many light colors as possible. You can use the bright colors for covering the sheet. Here I have completed coloring the peacock. I will be coloring the background now with orange color. The whole background also has to be colored with a thick layer. Now my sheet is completely colored and covered with the wax layer. I'm going to do something very horrible with the sheet, you will feel. I'm going to create some creases on the sheet. As you can see, you need to crumple the sheet properly so that a lot of folded lines are visible on the sheet. Make sure that you fold the sheet carefully so that it doesn't tear from inside. So I'll be creating some big folds on the sheet first, then I'll open it. And now on all the big parts, I'll be creating some small creases. As you can see, but be careful, the sheet shouldn't tear. Create the folds from all the sides. The crease has to be very deep, but it shouldn't tear the sheet. As you all can see from backside how many creases I have created on the sheet. So the creases which are created on the sheet have been de-waxed. Now I'm going to mix some poster color in the soap, and I'll mix a little bit water in this to create the dye. I'm using blue poster color to create the dye. You can use black or dark brown also. Depends on your design and the colors you have chosen in your design. I'm using Prussian blue. So here I'm adding a little bit water in this. Now mix this paste well with the brush. You can see the consistency of the color. Now start applying this paste very fast on your sheet. You would be thinking that I'm going to spoil the sheet completely, but it is not going to be spoiled. It will create a very beautiful effect. As you all can see, I'm covering the sheet very fast with this paste of soap and poster colors. Now immediately wash it off under the open tap, but you have to be very much careful because the sheet can tear from any side. So you have to hold it properly with your both hands, and the tap has to be opened very lightly. I know some mess is going to be created in the wash basin, but since we are using poster colors, you need not worry. You can easily wash your hands and in the wash basin also. Wash the sheet properly from all the sides. We are almost done. Now carefully put this wet sheet on a newspaper for drying. You need to keep it for drying at least for 1 to 2 hours. It will be dried completely. You can see the beautiful texture created on the sheet. This texture only, this print only, is called batik print, which is usually created on cloth. But here we have got a beautiful print on sheet. If you want, once the sheet is dried, you can iron it from backside. And here is the final result. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day ahead.